We've just concluded our summer school. It was a collaboration between Green Foundation Ireland and the Green European Foundation. And the subject was on the migrant crisis that we're experiencing here in Europe at the moment. Last night and Friday evening, we had a session where Mark Fielding, who's the CEO of ISMI, gave a clear message from business that migrants contribute to the Irish economy. In fact, 1 in 6 new businesses in Ireland are being started by migrants. The other interesting fact was he reported that in all economies across Europe, migrant, what they deliver into economies far outweighs any burden that they have in any national state. So they increase the capacity of skills and business experience to all economies. Brian Killoran, who is the Immigrant Council CEO, he reported back on research and practical travelling he did in Calais and in Dunkirk. And he saw horrendous conditions there, but he was particularly concerned with the lack of control and care of children. Children who are unaccompanied, children who are very vulnerable, and it needs to be addressed. And then Catherine Devitt, who is an environmental justice spokesperson who works with the Jesuit Faith Centre, she gave an extraordinary presentation of the problem that emigration is going to continue. It's a problem we're going to have to deal with, but in fact it's going to be exacerbated because climate change is going to impact it on a further and higher level. So unless we act on climate change and act on migration, her message was, get your act together. Today we had a great presentation by Barry Andrews, who is the CEO of Goal. Barry talked about their work in Syria. He talked clearly that Turkey was giving huge help to Syrian migrants, and they weren't complaining. They have over 2.5 million migrants on their shores and they're dealing with them. But he was pointing the finger at Europe. Even though Europe has taken in quite a lot, the states in Europe are not actually processing the migrants. We're not getting them into the jobs, we're not getting them into the community, we're not getting them as part of our economies, and we're not getting them as part of our countries. After that, we had Nessa Childers, who talked about the practical problems that the European Parliament is experiencing. The European Parliament is really, and the European Commission, are finding it very difficult to move the agenda on. And so there's a lack of leadership, is what she reported. Lack of leadership at European level and lack of leadership at national level. And then we had John Barry, who is a councillor in North Down. He was using and drawing on the experience in Northern Ireland of the sectarian problems there, but how they can overcome that and how they can use that experience with migration. And he said that local authorities, local councils could do an awful lot to improve the situation. And he also used his academic experience to talk about the messages and the way we communicate and the way we explain the migrant problem to people and how we get them to engage positively through positive messaging. In the afternoon, we had Sandy Dunlop. And Sandy, what Sandy actually did was he talked about the history of Ireland, the mythology that's in Ireland, that we are a migrant people. And as a migrant people, we have a great story and we've got a great tradition in taking migrants in. And this goes back thousands of years because everybody who came in Ireland was a migrant. And then we went through a very practical application where we got the participants today together to tell their own migration stories. Everybody, be they Irish or non-Irish there, were able to tell real experiences of migration, both in leaving the country and coming back. And that was quite cathartic, if you like. In our final session, we had Maria Giovanni Mineri, who is she's an advisor to the EU Parliament. And she talked about the real problems that were being experienced in the European Parliament in dealing with the problem. But she showed some tremendously practical examples from young people in Berlin, where they were producing small social media messaging, which showed how people can cooperate together at a local level. And she laid out for us 3 things that she believed that we need to get right and get right soon so that we begin to prepare for this continuing problem that is there. In summary, we've had a very invigorating and enlightening couple of days here in Dublin. And we're going to use the information that we have here to share it with other people across Europe. And hopefully we want to engage both people nationally at a low level and at European level to use some of the ideas that were generated in this seminar in a positive way and to give migration the proper attention, the proper support, and a proper future in the years ahead.